as you mentioned, the Supreme Court, probably after the PIL, is burdened with a lot of cases, probably many unnecessary cases. There are a lot of pending cases. Similarly, there are many issues associated with judiciary as well, like the appointment of judges, the collegium system came and it was declared unconstitutional. Sir, what are the things which you think that every system can be improved? Looking from the aspirant perspective, they are very much concerned about the stand they should take regarding the vision of the India. Like from the perspective of judiciary or from the perspective of the executive or from the parliament?
Well, I think the judges have themselves reflected on this very seriously. And sometimes they've taken a position and then in post-retirement, post-superannuation life, they've changed that position completely. Perhaps because of passage of time, more information coming in, experience of what they thought was the best method at that time. They have taken a second look, etc. But of course, the judge who retires can change his mind, but it doesn't matter because ultimately is the judge who is sitting in office who has to take the call. Maybe influenced by retired judges who have vast experience and who are respected, etc. But ultimately, is the judge sitting on the bench who would have to take a call. This is a very complicated area, and there is a very important segment of opinion in the country that the collegium system has inherent flaws in it. That it is not transparent enough, although efforts have been made to make it more and more transparent, that it's not transparent enough, it's not objective enough, it's still very much a close family thing, etc. And that you should make it open to people outside the judiciary, to scrutiny, to participation, for choices and so on. Which is why there was that attempt made to have the National Judicial Appointments Commission. It wasn't acceptable to the judiciary, for good reason it wasn't acceptable, but judiciary, as I said, have also shown to have second thoughts about it. Will political persons intervening be a good thing or not a good thing? I believe the jury is out on this. I don't have a very clear view, despite the fact that I've been law minister, that I have been in the legislature, and I would want to have a say, but I would be perhaps in some minority amongst public figures to say that I have serious doubts about my capacity or someone in my position, his capacity or her capacity to intervene in a wholesome manner to improve the appointment of appellate judges. I think we need to do some more thinking about it. There's feedback on what the three important judges' cases have done. I would say that they've added some improvements, etc., but the ultimate answer still is beyond our grasp. And I'm not sure that you take the pendulum to swing the other end completely and take it largely out of the hands of the judges to appoint their successors and leave it to public figures or politicians or what are described as persons of eminence. I'm a little worried about persons of eminence because the selection of a person of eminence may have the same problems as judges have in selecting judges. So I think that the jury's out on this. We need to think nationally. We need to think much more about it. Perhaps follow some examples elsewhere, but the social conditions and political conditions in other democracies are so vastly different from ours that their example may not be of much help.